Hi there, this is Colin Smith from Photoshop Cafe. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to do some basic video editing inside of Photoshop. So right now we've got Photoshop sitting here and you can see I've got the timeline open and no document. So what I'm going to do is I'm not going to create a document and then bring the video in. I'm just going to simply open the video. I'm going to choose File, Open. Then I'm going to go to the video and then click here. And then what it's going to do is it's going to open the video in Photoshop as a document. Now, the reason I did that is because I didn't want to have to figure out all the settings and have to put in the proper size, the proper codec, aspect ratio, all that stuff. By bringing the video into Photoshop, it creates a new document with exactly those settings for you. So you can see right now we've got a timeline here, and this is called a playhead, and I can drag the playhead to scrub through the video. And we can see different parts of the video. Now, I've turned the audio off. Here, if I have it on, you'll get sound. If I turn it off, you won't. So I've turned it off right now, so as you can hear me speaking over the footage. I'm gonna hit the space bar right now to play it. And what we have right now is I've actually done a little follow cam kind of a thing here with a car driving by, and I'm using a DJI Phantom quadcopter with a GoPro Hero 3 Black Edition on the bottom. In other videos, I show you how to remove the distortion and do some, get rid of some of the camera shake. In this video, we're actually gonna put some of the footage together and create a small sequence. So with the first clip added, if we wanna add more, we simply go down here and we can click on the video and we can choose Add Media. I'm gonna add two more. So I'm gonna simply click on the first one. Then I'm going to hold down the Command key and click on the second clip. That would be Control on Windows and click Open. Now when I do this, it adds all three to the timeline. You can't see them right now because there's too much going on to show it in the timeline at once. So we can go down here, we can use this little slider here, which enables us to zoom in and out of the timeline. Now it's not changing the speed or the duration of the video clips. All it's doing is shrinking down the timeline so we can see it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go to the next clip and hit the space bar and we can see what we've got. Here we go, we've got another shot where I'm flying over the top of the car. And then we'll let it continue. See, it's just like dead air at the end of that. And then we've got another one here where I'm hovering and along comes a car and now I start to follow the car with the copter. So you can see we've got these three different clips. So what we want to do, we don't want it here where the starts to get in the shot here. Our rotors and stuff are getting in the shot. So what we want to do is take the three clips and we want to trim them to length. So we're going to start with this one since it's running right now. I'm going to click and drag. Notice as soon as I click, you see a window which shows the duration of this particular clip, which is 10 seconds and 21 frames right now. And the entire project that we have right now, which is 31 seconds and 22 frames. So I'm just going to drag back, and you'll notice as I do that, we can stop right there where everything gets into the shot. Let's go to the beginning of the shot, and we're going to drag it until the car starts to appear. You'll see the shadow first, and then the car. So I'm going to release it right there. So what we've done now is we've trimmed this clip to only the, where the action is. Now, this hasn't thrown anything away. It's still there, and you can recover it at any time by clicking and dragging to bring it back. So these hidden areas are known as the head and the tail of the video. So it's still there, but we're just working non-destructively. So let's click on the next clip. I don't even have to have the playhead over the clip I'm working on. I can simply click and drag backwards until we get to the end, and let's go right there, where I've just gone to the end of the car. And let's go to the beginning, click and drag to where the car appears. And there we go. And now we've trimmed that one down. Let's go to the first clip. And we're just gonna click and drag. Notice it's right in there. So let's go to the end of that shot. And actually that's pretty good. We don't need any trimming on that shot. Notice though, that we've already trimmed this project down to 21 seconds and 18 frames. You can see that here, which is quite good. We've lost almost 10 seconds. Now remember, people have a short attention span, less is more. So trim your videos just down to the very, very important parts of action. All right, let's go back and we're gonna take the playhead to the beginning. I'm gonna hit the space bar and I'm gonna let it play. As it's playing, notice that it's becoming green behind the playhead and it's showing green at the bottom, saying it's playing in real time at 2997, which is 30 frames per second for argument's sake. If Photoshop was not able to keep up, it would show red and it would start to render these out. So what I've actually done is these clips we're working on right now, I've actually reduced the size down to 720. And if we actually go and look at the image and we go to image size, I'll show you what we've done. You can see I've got it down. If you don't see the pixels here, if it's in inches, you want to change it, or percentage, change it to pixels. And right now you see we're at 1280 by 720. This is the 720 HD size. So right now I'm working in 720 HD. Even though the footage was shot bigger, I could work on it bigger. I could work on it 1080 or the 2.7K, which was originally shot. But I'm working at it 720 because I've got much better performance just to demonstrate how this works. So if you find that your playback is a little bit sluggish, then let it play. And then once it's green like it is now, then when you hit the space bar to play again, this time it'll play through smooth, because now that it's green, that little bar there, see that? That green means that we're on RAM preview, meaning every single frame now is loaded into memory so we can play it back at the actual speed that the action is happening. So I just want to make you aware of that. So we've got these different clips. What if we want to change the order of the clips? Well, the first thing we want to do is we'll want to see where they live, and they live in the layers panel. So if we click on the layers panel here, you'll notice that we've got our three clips, and I just hit the top one and notice that the other two show. So what it's doing is, rather than how layers work, where it stacks from the top, from the bottom to the top, and loads images on top of each other, when we're working inside a video group, which is what you're going to get when you create a timeline like this, the video group is going to change it from stacking on top of each other to playing one after the other in duration. So chronologically speaking, the beginning is at the bottom and the end is at the top. So in time, it goes from early to late. So time climbs, time flies is a way to think about it. As it goes up, it goes across. So if we want to change the order of these clips, say for example, we're starting with this shot, what if we want to put that one in the middle? Well, we can click it, drag it, and release it. And now it's reordered them. Notice everything snaps in position here. That's because we're in a video group. And then what it does is it will snap everything into position and avoid those little gaps in there. This is also known as ripple editing, which is done automatically inside of Photoshop. So now we've got this first clip here that goes like this, this close-up shot where we fly away. Then we've got this one here, and then finally this one. I feel like I'd like to change the order of the first and the last one. Well, rather than having to click and drag these like that, we can actually do it from the layers panel. Take that one to the top, take that one to the bottom. And as I change it in there, notice it also changes it right here inside of the timeline. So sometimes it's easier to change your timeline by moving them around in layers than it is to move them in the timeline panel. So let's have a look at smoothing out these transitions. What we're going to do is create some nice dissolves, because if we look at it right now, we'll see where it goes from one to the next, very sudden. Although in a lot of movie making, these sudden cuts are very common and work very well. In this case, we're doing something that looks like a car commercial, so we want something a little bit smoother that gives us a nice feeling of just a very nice, soft, fuzzy feeling. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the transition button. We can change the duration of these transitions. I'm going to make it 2 seconds, and I'm going to choose the crossfade. So I'm going to click and drag that crossfade between the clips that I want to change. And I'm going to do the same thing here. So now if we go back and we play it, we'll see we've got this nice, smooth transition in between the clips. And then we'll let it play to the next clip and let it transition again. And there we go. So we get these nice transitions. Now, if you want to change these transitions after the fact, you can. by either right-clicking, we can change the type of transition, or we can change the duration of the transition, or we can delete it by hitting the little trash can. The other option is we can actually just click and drag here, and you'll see the duration is showing us. We can make it shorter or we can make it longer. In this case, I'm going to shorten it ever so slightly. And now if we want to play it back again, you'll notice the transition's quicker. Goes into that, and then the car goes off now, and then it's going to go into the other transition. Now, something that always looks good to finish these kind of things off is a fade to black and fade from black. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to choose here, and I'm going to choose fade with black. But this time I'm going to change the duration to 1.5 seconds. And now whenever I change the duration here, notice it's going to affect every single transition. That's how it works. If I set it there, it will affect every transition before I apply it. Now, once I've applied it, as you saw before, I can always change it. So we're going to do 1.5, and we're going to drag at the beginning, and I'm going to do 1.5, and I'm going to drag it at the end. I'm going to go back here, I'm going to hit the space bar, and notice it fades in, and you see a little jerk every now and then while things are loading up. And right now it's loading up into RAM. It's loaded up pretty well right now. It's playing as our transition. It's going to go back, and now it's going to fade from black out. And there we go. Right now I've just got it looping, so it's just going backwards and forwards. And you can see that we've got our video clip is playing. Now there's a lot of other things we can do. We can add sound. We can add different adjustment layers. There's a lot of different things. And in fact, what I'll do just for fun is I'll convert this to black and white, and I'll show you how to add that. We click on the top video group, and then I'm going to go under here, and I'm going to add a black and white adjustment. And this black and white adjustment, let me make sure that it's turned on to show all layers. If this clip art is turned on, it's only going to affect the layer directly underneath it, which in this case, you'll notice, will be the last clip. So what I'm going to do is turn that off so it affects all of them. And now we have this black and white video of this car going. Well, we can change all kinds of things with adjustment layers. If we wanted to add a curves adjustment, we could. And with this curves, let me just pop out the curve here a little bit. You could tend to plug up the shadow a little bit more, which is done a lot in movies. And if you wanted, you could open up the highlights. So what we've done is we've actually increased the contrast quite a bit. And this might not work so well in color, but in black and white is quite effective. So let's have a look. Once again, make sure that that clip is turned off. If it's clipping like that, hold down the Option key and then just click on the layer. And now it's going to affect all the layers underneath. So let's play it now. We've got our adjustment layers. We've got black and white now. And we've got the curve adjustment. And you can see that we've got this nice black and white effect. Now, if you wanted to take it even further and add a sepia tone, you could do that. In fact, you could apply any adjustment layer that we have here. One of the ways I like to apply a color, a cinematic color here, but before I do, notice one of the things that we've been having here when we've been applying these adjustments, as you've noticed, here's our adjustments here, that if we go into our properties here, you will see that we've got a lot of different things. When we click on our adjustments here, they now appear in the properties panel. So the other thing is the mask. If we wanted to add a mask, we could do that, but we're not going to do that right now. What we're going to do is I'm just going to go back down again, and I'm going to apply a solid color. Now with the color, I'm going to choose this. We want to do a sepia tone, so I'm going to grab an orangish color, click OK. And now I'm going to change the blend mode of this color because I want this blend mode. Notice though, before I do that, now that I've created this, notice it's just at the very end. I want to make you aware of that. What we need to do is drag it out and we put it on top. And then what we're going to do is we're going to grab this and drag it here all the way out. So now this lasts the same amount of time as our footage underneath. So if that's what happens, if you've got them appearing in here, do that. Now any of these, I could drag these out as well, but there's no need. But with the color one, I do need to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the blend mode to color. And now you can see the color come through. And to choose the amount of color that I want in here, all I simply do is adjust the opacity. So I'm going to take the opacity down and just give it just a little smidge about there. And now we've got this cool sepia tone video clip. Let me hit the play button here and you can see how that's going. And one of the other nice things about doing this, when we do this kind of effect, it really ties the footage together, because now the footage has this uniform color effect. Now, while I'm doing that, I'm going to show you one more thing. If I turn off the black and white, by applying this color adjustment, it gives a feel or a look to our entire footage. So now you can see here, this footage has got this really warm kind of a color tone, because it's not black and white anymore. And so sometimes if you want a cinematic look, all you need is two things. One, increase the contrast here with your curves like we did, and add a little bit of a color cast. You can change the color cast. Double click, and we could go, say, a greenish hue, so we get something that looks like it's out of the Matrix. And now we can play it back, and notice that all the footage now has this green tint to it. So you can see how easy it is to apply these different adjustment layers to the video to get different feels to your video and just really change the mood of it entirely. So when you're done, you can simply save this document. And the wonderful thing about saving the document is that everything we've done is going to stay within the document. Now, the footage is linked, so you need to keep the original footage on your hard drive. It's pretty robust, actually, because if you move your footage around within the drive, Photoshop is still going to keep it connected. But if you move it off the drive to another drive, it's not going to work. It's going to be looking for that footage. However, all our edits, our transitions, our adjustments, all the things that we do here are all going to be contained within this one document when we save it out as a PSD. When you're ready to share it with the world, go down here, click the render button, and then we can choose options. In a nutshell, we're going to give it a name, we're going to choose where we want it to go. Then the options you have is, right now we're just going to work with Adobe Media Encoder. Right now it's going to H.264, which is a standard sharing format that works on YouTube, iPhones, iPads, Apple TVs, Android, even Blu-ray players use H.264. It's pretty much the standard right now. So you could choose that, and or you could go down to QuickTime. But under H.264, let's look at some of the presets. You can do high, medium, or low, and that'll take the size and the frame rate we have. Or we can even change it to work on all these different devices, even YouTube, Vimeo, Android phones, Apple TV, and it will actually size the video for you and you'll be good to go. You don't even need to know what the settings mean. So when you're done, you simply click render, and then it's going to create a movie in the location that you have chosen, and then you can share it with other people. So I hope this has helped you, and you'll find that as you start to play with video in Photoshop, there's a lot of options here that are available. And don't forget to come back to Photoshop Cafe, because I'm going to have a lot more tutorials on video in Photoshop. I actually have a book on it as well, which is called Video in Photoshop. And there's a lot more I can teach you about this topic. But for now, this is enough to get you started. I hope you enjoyed.